Craigie Garain lost 100,000 pesos over the weekend as one of the victims of the unauthorized withdrawal cyber attacks which targeted BDO depositors. He has filed complaints with the Philippine Central Bank, the Philippine National Police, and the National Bureau of Investigation, and he has joined a support group online which he says has ballooned to over 200 confirmed victims.
Sabi po ng BDO, kailangan po namin maghintay ng 5 po na banking days bago namin malaman yung result po ng investigation nila. So gusto po sana namin malaman din sa BDO kung ano po yung timeline, kung kailan po ma-reimburse yung mga pera po namin na pinaghirapan.
Reports place the amount of money lost per victim at anywhere between 40,000 and 200,000 pesos. House Deputy Minority Leader Carlos Zarate has filed a resolution to start a congressional hearing into the matter, and he was especially critical of BDO's reimbursement process.
Padadaanin mo pa sila dito sa butas ng karayom. Malinaw naman sa lumalabas talaga dito, yung system nila ang na-compromise. Mag-isip din sila kung paano maproteksyonan yung interest ng ating mamamayan, the depositors especially, by adapting modern technology, for example. And if they fail to comply with that, then that's a prima facie evidence na meron silang pagkukulang, no? Doon sa due diligence.
Senator Joel Villanueva has proposed the formation of a multi-agency task force to quickly resolve the issue so the Philippines won't become an easy target for cyber criminals. Many of the victims are also confused and frustrated because of BDO's statement on the matter, which reads, "We assure our affected innocent clients that we will reimburse their losses." The victims claim they were told they would also be investigated to check if they are innocent. Technology journalist Art Samaniego, meanwhile, says it's possible BDO was the victim of what is known as a zero-day exploit or zero-day vulnerability. The name implies the target of the cyber attack had 0 days to prepare because it did not know what was coming.
Meron kasi isang exploit na lumabas kung saan pwedeng makontrol ng mga kriminal yung server mo at pwede nilang gawin kahit ano doon. Kasama na doon yung pagnanakaw ng mga pera. Kung meron kang pera. Ang tawag dito, zero day. Yung zero day vulnerability, ibig sabihin nun, wala pang gamot, wala pang bakuna laban sa exploit na yun na ginagawa ng mga cyber criminals. Pag ganito, walang laban talaga yung mga kumpanya, pati mga bangko.
Samaniego says, this is a prime example of why cybersecurity must constantly be updated and upgraded. Samaniego also urges the public to change passwords regularly, avoid suspicious links and websites, and keep personal data safe and secure.
Ang mga bank accounts kasi natin, yung mga online bank accounts natin, meron siyang mga limit, di ba? Pwede ka mag-set ng limit. So pag kailangan mo ng pera, i-change mo yung limit dun sa kailangan mong pera. Pagkatapos, pag di mo na kailangan, ibalik mo sa zero yung limit na pwedeng transactions.
Meanwhile, National Privacy Commission Chairman Raymond Liboro says they are waiting for BDO's data protection officers to determine if the cyber criminals made off with more than just cash. He says BDO has 72 hours or 3 days from the discovery of the cyber attack to determine if any personal data was also stolen. If yes, they will have to notify all data subjects whose information was compromised. BDO says it is still determining how many depositors were affected by the attacks and how much money was stolen. BDO is also coordinating with the National Bureau of Investigation in the search for the criminals behind the unauthorized withdrawals. Warren De Guzman, ABS-CBN News.